lecture is going to be on eddy current inspection of heat exchanger tubing. Tubing inspection is one of the major applications of eddy current testing. This kind of testing is used for inspection of heat exchangers in petrochemical plants, power plants, and in nuclear plants. The equipment used for this inspection is much more sophisticated than the equipment that is used for surface inspection. Here, let me introduce you to the equipment that is used for tubing inspection. This is a machine, eddy current machine, which is a multi-frequency machine. It can excite like four frequencies simultaneously and produce different channels, like differential and absolute channels, and these channels can be mixed to produce a mixed channel. The machine is actually controlled by a software from this laptop, and then we connect a bobbin probe to the machine, which is like this, and the coils of the bobbin probe are right here. There are two coils. They operate in the differential mode, and here is a calibration tube. In the calibration tube, there are actually five flaws which are machined. Here is a 100% deep hole, 80% flat bottom hole, 60%, 40%, and 20%. The size of these holes is as per ASME section 5. The first step for this inspection is the calibration. In the calibration, we actually would enter the material, the thickness of the tube, which is in this case 14 gauge or 0.083 inches, and then we have the machine select the frequencies. The machine has selected frequencies like 100 kilohertz and 50 kilohertz. Then we will accept the frequencies, and the machine is now set up with those two frequencies, which are 100 kilohertz and 50 kilohertz. The next thing is let me pull the probe in the calibration tube. Here are the signals from the calibration tube. As you can see, the first signal is from the hole, through all hole, 80%, 60%, 40%, and 20%. The signal from the hole is set to 40 degrees, which is right here, it's saying 37, and if I want to reset it to 40, I'll just do a calibrate here, set the hole to 40 degrees, and it's set up to 40 degrees. And here we can see the differential 100 kilohertz channel, the differential 50, the absolute 50, and the mixed channel. The mixed channel is used for mixing out the support plate signal in the heat exchangers. So in this case, in our calibration tube, this is the signal from the support plate, and it's right here, which is shown on the mixed channel right here on the bottom right hand side, and we can actually mix out the signal by following this process, and just watch, this signal will be mixed out to zero. So when I click calibrate, the signal is gone, so there is no signal here from the support plate. And if I play the mixed signal here on the strip chart, you will notice that there is no signal from the mixed channel. The next step in calibration is to create the depth curves. The depth curves are a relationship between the eddy current phase angle and the depth of the flaw, and we create these depth curves on the calibration tube. Here we have the signal from the calibration tube. This is the hole, and we will create the depth curve right here. So I'll measure the phase angle of the hole, which is 40 degrees. Then I'll go to the 60% deep flat bottom hole, measure it, then the 20%, and then measure it. And here we have the depth curve, and these are the phase angles from the 80%, 60%, 40%, and 20%. The x-axis here is the phase angle, which goes from 0 to 180 degrees, and the y-axis is the depth of the flaws, which is from 0 to 100%. Now, for example, if the phase angle on the actual flaw is measured as 90 degrees, which would be here, then the estimated depth of the flaw would be about 80%. This side of the depth curve is the ID flaws, and this side of the depth curve are the OD flaws. So once the depth curves are set up, we save the calibration file, and then we are ready to perform the inspection. Thank you.